Welcome students to Navin sir physics classes. So in last lecture we discussed about the trigonometric functions or basic trigonometry we discussed. So in this session we are going to discuss about basic coordinate geometry. Sir, where we can use this basic coordinate geometry in physics? Let us discuss in detail from the beginning of the basic coordinate geometry. So for suppose if you want to represent or if you want to specify a point in a space, with the help of coordinate geometry, it can be done. So basic coordinate geometry. The main use of this basic coordinate geometry or coordinate geometry is to specify the point in a space. So this basic coordinate geometry consists of origin and axis or axis. Sir, what is origin? So origin is nothing but any fixed point which is convenient to you. Sir, what is axis? So axis is nothing but it is a line passing through the origin in any direction. So for suppose if the axis, this is a fixed point you are assuming, so through this point if this axis is moving, so this line is moving, it is considered as one axis. For suppose generally we can consider the line, the horizontal line or the axis which is passing through the horizontal, it is known to be x-axis, and which is perpendicular to the x-axis passing through the origin is called as y-axis, and if it is one more axis perpendicular to both x and y, that is known to be z-axis. So we have to represent the position of a point. For suppose it is along the line, so if it is along the line, it is 1D, one dimensional, and if we are locating that in a plane, so we can see three planes here. So one is xy plane and this is yz plane and this is zx plane. So three planes due to intersection of the three axes we are going to get. So if the point P is locates in a plane, that is known to be two dimensional, and if the point P is represented in a three axis with the three points, it is three dimensional. That means for suppose if your point is there P, so P is a point 1, 0, 0. What does it mean? The point P is along x axis. How far from the origin? 1 unit from the origin. For suppose if you take point P is given as 2, 4. What does it mean? So from the x-axis, along x-axis it is 2 units from the origin, and along y-axis it is 4 units from the origin. In the same way, if you are representing a point P in a space, so P of 2, 4, 5, what does it mean? From the along x-axis 2 meter, y-axis 4 meter, z-axis 5 meter from the origin. That is the representation of a point in 1D. So if it is 1D, it has only one coordinate. If it is 2D, it has three coordinates, so that may be x comma y, or y comma z, or z comma x. And here also y, or it may be z. In three dimension, it has x coordinate, y coordinate, and z coordinate. And now let us see some problem related to this. So in a plane, there are two points are located. So P1, x1 comma y1, and P2, x2 comma y2. So we want to find the distance between these two points. So there is a formula to find out distance between the points. Distance between the points is given by d equals to under root of x2 minus x1 whole square plus y2 minus y1 whole square. Okay, right. So this is the distance between the points. Sir, for suppose if you want to find out the distance of the point P1 from the origin. So distance of the point P, distance of P1 from origin, if we complete this, we can get a right angle triangle here. This is x1 and y1, it is hypotenuse here. You are going to get x1 square plus y1 square. So this is the distance of the point P from origin. So similarly, we are going to get distance of point P2 from origin, x2 square plus y2 square. In the same way, the midpoint, you want to find out the midpoint on the line joining the two points. So x1 plus x2 by 2, y1 plus y2 by 2. So this is about in locating the points and to find the distance between the points. And here we need to learn some more information about the geometry. So that is slope of a line. Slope of a line. So slope represented by M here. Let us take a line in a space like this. So with the points x1 comma y1, with point x2 comma y2. So now they are asking what is the slope of this line made by the with respect to x-axis. They are asking theta. So now we know that it is P. So P is x1 comma y1, Q is x2 comma y2. So we can write the slope formula y2 minus y1 by x2 minus x1. Sometimes the slope we can also represent directly in tan theta. Tan theta equals to m. If the angle is given, for suppose theta is given as 30 degree, so directly you can take to find or to express the slope. If you take the tan values, you are going to get the slope of. So for the tan given, we are going to get m is equals to 1 by root 3. Okay, sir, where we are using the slope of a line in physics? So let us take this application in physics. If you plot a graph between position time. The slope of position time graph gives velocity because v equals to delta x by delta t. If you take the two points on the line, so you can get the coordinate as p coordinate as t1 comma x1 and q coordinate as t2 comma x2. If you take the slope nothing but what here, v equals to dx by dt. Slope is equals to speed or velocity of an object we are going to get. In the same way, if you plot the graph between velocity and time, so slope of vt graph gives acceleration. Okay, in the same way, if you plot a graph between momentum and a time, so you are going to get force delta p by delta t. Okay, na? In this way, we are using the slope formula in physics. Okay, let us study some more equations. So, graphical representations we will discuss. So, generally, the straight line equations is follows like this: ax plus by plus c equals to 0. So this is a general expression, general equation of a straight line. Next, equation of x-axis, equation of x-axis y equals to 0, equation of y-axis is x is equals to 0. Next, in the same way, if you want to write y is equals to mx, so y is equals to mx is nothing but y and x. The nature of the graph is a straight line. Passing through origin. So this is important. Okay, now if you see y equals to mx format between the two physical quantities, the nature of the graph compulsory straight line passing through the origin. Let us apply this to physics. Okay, so the quantity is given like this: p equals to mv. We know that linear momentum is the product between mass and velocity. So if mass is constant, we can write p directly proportional to p directly proportional to v. If p is constant, p directly proportional to m. So in these we are going to get by taking p along y-axis, v along x-axis in the format of y is equals to mx. So we are going to get the graph like a straight line passing through the origin. Or in the same way, v equals to, for suppose an object starts from rest, attains a velocity v moving with acceleration a in time t. Okay, so we can write from first equation of motion, v equals to u plus a t. So here u value is 0. So v 0 plus a t, therefore v equals to a t. So if you plot a graph between velocity and time, y along y axis velocity and along x axis time, we can get a graph which is passing through the origin, and the slope of that, if you compare this, y is equals to mx. So slope is equals to acceleration of the object. In this way, we can apply this equation to physics. And next, let us see another expression, y equals to mx plus c. So So what is the meaning of this y equals to mx plus c? So the slope of the graph is m and it cuts the positive y-axis. So the graph will be like this. So it is a straight line only, but it has some interception. So what is the interception? Positive interception. That positive interception is c, and m is positive y x. So now let us apply this. So we have a first equation of motion, v equals to u plus at. If the object is moving with zero speed, starting speed is zero, then we are getting the graph between a and v and t as a straight line. For suppose if u is not equals to zero, then what is the expression we are going to get? V equals to u plus at. Now let us compare this with y equals to mx plus c. V equals to at plus u. Now we are going to get the graph like this. By taking v along y axis, time along x axis, it has interception c. This interception gives the initial velocity of an object. So u not equals, that means the object started its journey with some initial velocity, and the slope is same. Slope is equals to a only. A is equals to v by t. Sometimes we have an expressions in the format of y is equals to mx minus c. So y is equals to mx minus c, slope is positive, m is positive only, and but c is negative interception. That means the graph, it cuts the negative y-axis. The graph is like this. So this is negative interception. So minus c. Slope m equals to, again, tan theta, we can do it. So this is along y-axis and x-axis. So for this, I will give one example to you. So in plus 2, we are going to study photoelectric equation. In that photoelectric equation, we are getting the expression like this, k equals to E minus W, or k equals to h nu minus W, we are going to write. So they are going to plot the graph between, by taking k along y-axis and frequency of the radiation along x-axis. So they will get a graph similar to the what we have discussed. So this is negative interception. So this negative interception gives work function here. It is the nature of the material. W is work function, and slope is equals to Planck's constant. So in this way we can analyze the graphs. Okay. Right, next. For suppose if it is inverse proportion, so y inversely proportional to x, so then the nature of graph is parabola. Sorry, the nature of graph is hyperbola. This is hyperbola. And for suppose if y inversely proportional to x square, the nature of graph we are going to get rectangular hyperbola like this. So deep curve, and it is slightly like this. Okay, the difference between the two graph you can understand. So it is deep curve. If it is deep curve is there, it is rectangular hyperbola. It is only hyperbola. Okay, so where we can get this graph? We have so many expressions like this. When Boyle's law, P inversely proportional to V. So when if you plot a graph between by taking pressure along y-axis, volume along x-axis, then we are going to get the graph like this. As volume increases, pressure decreases. In the same way, in gravitational law we can write F equals to G into M1, M2 by R square. If this is constant, we can write F inversely proportional to R square. The graph between F and R square is rectangular hyperbola. Okay, so this is the importance of these two expressions. The nature of the graphs are important. So we should identify what kind of relation between the given quantities in the expression, for which quantities we are plotting the graph. That is important because graphical analysis is very, very important in physics. Okay, now sometimes we are getting the results in graphical manner, so that graphical values we are going to solve the problems. Okay, so for suppose here if you plot the graph between by taking P along y axis 1 by V along x axis, then it will be straight line, because if the quantity is 1 by V we are taking along x axis, then it will be a straight line. If you take only V along x-axis, it will be a hyperbola, otherwise it will be straight line. Here also same, if you take F along y-axis 1 by R square along x-axis, then graph will be straight line. Okay, so wherever we can get this kind of relation between the physical quantities, we are going to represent the graph between the quantities in the same sense. Right. Some more expressions will be there, so that will also let us complete. So x square plus y square is equals to a square. So this is equation of a circle. Okay, x square plus y square is equals to a square. Next, in the same way, for suppose if it is x by a plus y by b equals to 1. So this expression shows the graph cuts the x axis at a and y axis at b. This is the nature of this. Okay. Next, for suppose if x square by a square plus y square by b square is equals to 1, so it is ellipse. Right. Next, let us see what are the expressions for the parabola. So we can write a quadratic equation like y is equal to ax square plus bx plus c. If b equals to 0, c equals to 0, then we can write y is equal to ax square. So this is the expression for a or equation of a parabola. So parabola equation. So we know that if x is equal to 0, y equals to 0. So we are writing about equation of parabola. Right. So here two types of graphs we are going to get. That too depends on the a value. If a is positive, then we are going to get the graph like this. Okay, next, if a is negative, then the graph is inverted. Okay, so the nature of the graph is decided by the value a. So if y is equal to ax square, if a is positive, it is upward, and if it is y equals to minus ax square, it will be inverted to the first position. In the same way, this we can also express, x is equal to ay square sometimes. If x is equal to ay square, we can represent the graph like this. This is if a positive. This is if a is negative. Sir, for suppose if c is 0 but b not equals to 0, now can we get it? Then we can get the expression ax square plus bx. So then the nature of graph will be like this. So it is not symmetrical. The graph will be like this. So this is minus b by a, minus b by 2a. This value will be minus b square by 4a. This we are going to get when y is equal to 0, then x is equal to 0 or x is equal to minus b by a. At x is equal to minus b by 2a, y is minimum. So this value is known to be vertex. A is known to be vertex. Okay, na? So b square by 4a. This value is known to be vertex. That means vertex nothing but where the graph is going to take a turn. So this is about a basic coordinate geometry, so which helps to study some physical, in physics, some expressions. Okay, na? Right. In last lecture, I forgot to discuss about some trigonometric relations. Okay, na? So in that, let us write some trigonometric relations here. So sine square theta plus cos square theta equals to 1. The same way, secant square theta minus tan square theta equals to 1. And then some operations, sine of a plus or minus b equals to sine a cos b plus or minus cos a sine b, and cos of a plus or minus b equals to cos a cos b minus or plus sine a sine b. Okay, na? So these are the some expressions. We can also write some more, sine 2a or sine 2 theta equals to 2 sine a cos a. We can write cos 2a, we can write cos square a minus sin square a, we can write. So this expression we can also write 2 cos square a minus 1 also we can write. Okay, these are the some relations for trigonometric functions. Okay. let us see some algebraic expression in this. So basic algebra we will discuss. So in basic algebra, I think so you know the formulas like a plus b whole square equals to a square plus b square plus 2ab, a minus b whole square equals to a square plus b square minus 2ab. That formulas and all you know. So I am going to discuss about the polynomial, linear and quadratic functions. Okay, na? So let us take generally a polynomial or a real polynomial can be expressed like this. If a naught, a1, a2 and so on an are real numbers, and x is a real variable, then we can express the function f of x as a naught plus a1x plus a2x square and so on plus an x power n is known to be real polynomial. So here some terms let us study, that is degree or index. So degree or index nothing but it is the highest power in a polynomial. Poly means more, right? For suppose the function is given like this, f of x is equal to x power 4 minus x cube minus x square minus x plus 1. So in this highest power is what? 4. So this is known to be degree of the polynomial or index of the polynomial. So the highest power should not be only in one variable. Sometimes this can be also written as x cube into y square minus x power 4 minus x cube, like that. So here highest power is what? 3 plus 2, that is 5. This is the order or degree of the polynomial. Okay. So here we are getting different types of the equations. So linear equation. So what is linear equation? If the expression is like this, x plus y equals to 2 or ax plus by plus c equals to 1 or 0, it is a linear polynomial. So linear equation nothing but a polynomial with a degree or index 1, that is known to be linear equation. Then quadratic equation. So quadratic if the degree of the polynomial is 2, then we can say it as a quadratic equation. So here the roots of the quadratic equation is important. So if you want to find out the roots for this, x is equal to minus b plus or minus root of v square minus 4ac by 2a. Here we are going to get two roots for x value. So what are that value? Two roots. There I am considering first root will be alpha. So alpha minus b plus root of v square minus 4ac by 2a, and beta minus b minus b square minus 4ac by 2a. Now here you will get some formulas here. The sum of roots, that is alpha plus beta, is equal to minus b by a. Next, product of roots alpha into beta equals to c by a, and the difference of roots is equals to b square minus 4ac by 2a. So let us take one application based on the quadratic equation in physics. Let us take an object is thrown vertically upwards. So when an object is thrown vertically upwards above the surface of earth, its acceleration we can consider as minus g, and whatever the distance traveled, that means vertical distance traveled on reaching the highest point is h, and time taken is t, and initial velocity is as final velocity is 0. Now let us see, when the object is thrown vertically upwards, it won't stay there at highest point only. Again, after reaching the highest point, it reaches to the ground. Okay. So when it reaches to the ground, it has 2 times at which the object is at same height. One is while it is going up, or suppose it is at point P, and the same way while it is coming down also it is at same level. That means this time will be T2. So we are getting 2 times here. Let us write the expression. What is the equation of this? S is equals to ut plus half a t square is second equation of motion. Let us apply the second equation of motion. If the vertical distances, we are taking h, u value is ut minus half gt square. So 2h ut, 2ut minus gt square. Therefore, it is written as gt square plus, you can take this side, 2ut plus 2h is equals to 0. If we observe this in the format of ax square plus bx plus c, so with this information, we can find out the product. So T1, T2 we can find, T1 plus T2 we can find. With the help of that, we are going to get some important information related to this vertically projected upward motion. Okay, so these are the some basic knowledge of mass required for physics. So if any concept is missed related to the basic mathematics, so when the topic will come, at that time I will discuss that concept, whatever the required concept that I will discuss. Take care, stay safe.